right to you about. Something like that. My name is Shaun Sutton.
Oh my.
I'm going to try to convince you guys and persuade you on life on other planets. Yes. Probably more than thousands and thousands of years is the life out there. Is there other habitable planets on Earth? Well, one of my fact claims are Earth is not the only planet within our galaxy that is able to sustain life. As you can see from my little video here, the moons of Jupiter, there are billions and billions of stars within our galaxy alone. The Milky Way galaxy is one of the main galaxies in our universe, in the whole universe. There might be a parallel universes, but this is ours. According to NASA and research with the Kepler Space Telescope, they have found such a place. Found another Earth. Kepler 22b. This is the star Kepler 22b. Sorry for the lights. It's a planet system 600 light years away. The main fact is sustained life, but Kepler 22b, the planet, is a water planet. And with research and stuff, Scientific America stated that this planet is uninhabitable, although it does contain most of the elements that we have here on Earth, but it's mostly water. The discovery in 2011 by NASA and the Kepler Space Telescope revealed a sun-like star with a single planet orbiting it within the habitable zone. Does anybody understand what the habitable zone is?
It's the distance you need to be away from the source of heat.
Yeah,
to maintain a sustainable temperature on the planet.
Yes. The sweet spot is
the Goldilocks.
Yeah, the Goldilocks area. What was that? And this planet that they found is in the constellation Cygnus. Does anybody know about astronomy here? Well, Cygnus is in the southern hemisphere. I think it's in like early April or so that you can see this constellation. And they focused telescopes and the Kepler Space Telescopes in this area to discover all these, and they found so many, lots of planets over there. They named the system Kepler in honor of Johannes Kepler. He was a 17th century icon that, what did they say? They said that he was an icon in the 17th century.
He created the printing press.
What was that?
He created the printing press.
No, not the printing press. No, it's the laws of planetary motion. So he discovered the other planets over there. Kepler 22 star is a star very much like our own sun. It's a G5V class star that runs hydrogen into helium to produce energy. Kepler 22b, I don't have a picture of it. I should have had a picture of it, but the planet here is, I'll get to that. it's a planet that orbits the sun-like star. It's within the habitable zone of the star, like Earth. However, it contains elements to which we are unknown about. We do know what it is mostly made up of. Why? Because of this life comes. Life would not exist on this planet. Compared to our own Earth, it lacks terrain and may perhaps drift away from its star, causing temperature drops too intense for life to survive. Now, there are numerous systems out there within our galaxy and within our own Milky Way galaxy. I'm pretty sure with all these galaxies within our solar system, or not our solar system, our universe, suns, planets, moons, it's highly possible that life is out there. What do you believe? What do you believe, Carter?
It's not far-fetched. I mean,
Victor, what do you believe?
Obviously, I believe that the possibility of the green lines outside of Earth and the type is so many other planets out there. But I also believe that, I can get to know that.
We could go on for hours and hours. I could go on all day about this crap. What we call it crap, but this other. Who else can I pick on here? Athena, what do you believe?
I believe that there's a possibility that there's alternate universes.
That's the one thing that can be
Correct.
I'm not going to go into that.
It's a completely different
subject. Well, to move on to another subject of the same enlightenment, many findings by the Kepler Space Telescope have yet found another planetary system slightly closer than Kepler 22b. It's a system 400 light years away and still within the constellation Cygnus. A planet which they call is in the sweet spot of Goldilocks.
Goldilocks. Yeah, so then if it's a sustainable planet, it's called Goldilocks.
Yes. And well, on my little video here, it shows the actual planet. There it is. Can you guys see that? I'll shut off the lights for a quick second so you guys can see it. That, my friends, is Kepler 186f. It's about 10% larger than the Earth, whereas Kepler 22b is enormous, super huge, and not to mention water. Compared to our Earth, this planet, Kepler 186f, has elements that are possible for life. Elements such as water, land, possibly oxygen. It orbits a star on an orbiter with a habitable zone, but still within that sweet spot. Two systems of life. The problem is getting there to find out if there's life there. That would take at least 20,000 years for us just to get there with our technology. Many other planets found by the Kepler Space Telescope do in fact resemble Earth, but are not within that habitable zone for us to survive on the planets. Some are quite large and some are small. It all depends on which one of these many planets that we find are susceptible to sustained life, and not to mention, can we get there? Now, I'd like to move on to our own planetary system. Where was it? There. We look at our own planetary system, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Neptune, Uranus, and we'll include Pluto, even though it's considered a dwarf planet.
There's some other planets in the same
yeah,
area as Pluto.
They have found it with the
three other
smaller things. With two of our own planets in mind, Jupiter and Saturn, think about this possibility. Jupiter was once a failed star. Anybody find that interesting?
What's a what?
A failed star. Failed, why? Why? Does anybody ask that? Why is it a failed star? Well, the reasons maybe that it failed are in fact stated by NASA and astronomy.com. According to them, Jupiter is large as planets go, and it will need to be about 75 times its current mass to ignite nuclear fusion in its core and become a star. We have already looked within our own solar system for Earth-like planets. Titan, as you've seen on the video there, we've looked at that planet so many times, or moon, I should say. It's about the same size of our Earth. It has atmosphere, terrain, and what scientists say looks like water, but cannot possibly be water, but an elemental form of liquid that cannot freeze, such as liquid nitrogen. According to Scientific America, it is stated that Titan's water, Titan's liquid is not water, but a form of liquid nitrogen. That being, the moon is too far away from our sun to be warm enough for human habitation. So in turn, will it farther away from our own solar system for other Earth-like planets? Thanks to the Kepler Space Telescope, we have found other Earths. The only problem is